will give you a completely different story. As an example, I will give. One of the major claims of our Christian brothers and sisters is that Jesus Christ has to be God. Why? He brought the dead back to life. Born lepers cleared them. Born blind. If you don't mind being a bit patient. Yeah. So that is what happens. Now, I would ask you, okay, this is what he says. Yeah. The claim is that he brought the dead back to life, Lazarus.
Yeah.
Yeah? Born blind, lepers, he cured them all. Yeah. Okay? Drove devils out of people and into pigs.
He did it.
Hmm? Yeah. He did it all.
Okay.
Now, commonly speaking, normal human beings can't do that.
Yeah.
So there was something special about this guy. Yeah? What was special about him? Was he divine? Or was he a prophet of God? And he was carrying out the instructions of God. Yeah? And this is commonly repeated by me. I usually refer my Christian friends to the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 22.
Yeah.
It tells you there, "Hear, O Israel, Jesus Christ, a man approved of God by miracles, wonders and signs which God did through him." Now in normal English, what does that mean? God did it through him. Now we haven't even touched the original language here. Yeah. Now the amazing thing is, listen to the evidence. This story about the dead back to life is Lazarus. That is found in the Gospel of John chapter 11 verse 41 onward. That is where he says, now listen to the language that is employed. This is the translated element, okay? He says, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me."
So?
"I know that you always hear me."
Yes.
One second.
We're having a very wonderful conversation.
Thank you. Don't disturb. Thank you.
Go on, my brother.
Yeah? So he says, "I thank you that you have heard me."
Yeah.
"I know that you always hear me."
Yeah.
"But because of the people that stood by, I said it, so that they may believe you have sent me."
Yes.
Now when he says, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me," what did he say? According to the Gospel of John, what did he say?
"The Father had sent the Son."
Right, you will note, I'm asking a question, I'm not asking for belief, I'm asking on an evidential basis. In the Gospel of John, I am fully flesh, my sister. Yeah, you will find. No, I'm asking a very reasonable question. You see, sister, this is the problem I find. We are having such an intelligent discussion. My sister, I don't mind your belief. I don't mind your belief. Okay. But if we can just go to John chapter 11, you will find that he says, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me."
Okay. Yes.
What my question is, okay, what did he ask for? Can anyone answer? Can you tell me? What did he ask for? No, that's what you want to believe. What do the facts say? Have a read of it. Go to chapter 11.
Okay.
Can I?
It's nice to see people's reaction
that you raised Lazarus from the dead.
Here he says, yeah, when they bring him to the tomb. He said, "But the Lord said, Martha, the sister of the dead man, by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days." Yeah, he had been in the tomb. Verse 40, "Then Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believe, you would see the glory of God?"
Yes.
Verse 41, "So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I know that you always hear me." As I repeated.
Okay, I need to read it.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Yes.
Now the question is, he just says, "Father, I thank you that you have heard me." What did he ask for?
Do you want an answer?
Now you will find my reasoning is, and I will come back to you, brother.
Because
I'll come back to you, brother.
You're convincing them and you're speaking alone. You don't want anybody to give you any views. You don't want anybody to speak.
Brother,
he's got a mic.
Brother.
It's a propaganda. Look at that. He's got a mic.
Brother.
But can I ask you a question?
Brother.
It's a simple question.
Brother. There are two of you. I will finish with my
Bible. Hold on.
I'll finish with my sister.
You're reading the Bible and you've not put out your Quran once. Where's your Quran?
Let him finish and then we'll go to the Quran. I make a deal with you. We go to the Quran.
You're arguing based on your own knowledge.
Sheikh, no. You are entirely right. You are entitled to your opinion. Anyway, sister, let's carry on. Can we carry on? Can we carry on? Sister, brother,
leave him, Allah, brother, leave him.
Don't worry. You see, I know. Don't worry, it's nothing to do with
this. I see what you're saying, but this is what I have trouble with your argument.
Go ahead.
The problem I have with your argument, Uncle G.
Sorry, sir.
The problem I have with your argument, Uncle G, is that it's you know, essence, right? Essences, right? So it's like, let me.
No problem. Calm down. It's okay. Don't worry about it.
So yeah, this is my first time here.
I know. Don't worry about it.
Brothers,
if you don't mind, it's not fair, brother. You are putting under intense pressure. Can you move away? I promise you, I will come and discuss with you guys. Okay, let us finish. Have a bit of decency.
I want to hear as well. Have a bit of decency. You see, you've been speaking,
brother.
Sir. You're controlling.
You are being very rude.
You're controlling the situation.
As you can see,
you're controlling. It's not going to work. No. That is not fair. Why should he speak?
Unfortunately, when you are trying to have a rational discussion, they can't.
You disagree with me, Lex.
Exactly. I don't know. That's how they
are.
Apologies about this, but it is not intended, unfortunately. That's how they are. Yeah.
Right now.
Brilliant.
Right
no problem.
Now.
Brilliant. No problem.
I don't understand what has to do with the mic. Everybody can see it. It's not hiding the mic.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry. We are having a good conversation here. Let's keep it at that.
Whatever.
Yeah.
You're twisting the truth.
Sorry.
Exactly. You're twisting the truth.
Thank you.
I'm a Christian as well. I'm a Christian as well. I don't believe in what he says.
My dear,
he has the freedom to say what he has to say. But something else.
Look how he knows.
Wait, one question. Hey, who answered my question?
Where's Muhammad?
He won't answer my question.
Are you taking this?
Are you hiding?
Good.
Answer my question.
Good. We don't want to put you in this.
What's the worst going to happen? At the end, we're going to disagree. That's the worst thing that's going to happen.
Exactly.
You know what, sister? Don't worry. Don't worry about them. I'm glad you came here. That's a good idea. Yeah, so apologies about this, my dear. Don't worry about it, yeah? Don't worry about it. He's getting a bit calm. Oh, I like that muscle man is there. It's all right. It's what it is. Yeah? Actually, we I know. What actually?
You see,
we have to have a discussion here. That's why we're here.
No worry, absolutely. That's all we are doing.
My sister,
no problem. God bless you.
So, takir is okay in Islam?
My sister, God bless
it's
you.
It's not okay in Christian.
No problem.
Christian.
No problem. Don't worry about it. Yeah. No problem, sister. You are okay. The brothers want to discuss with you. Yeah?
Let me just give you a good answer. Anything you disagree about Islam, we agree with you.
Okay, is that all right? Now let's go.
Sir, that's it. Discuss,
you know? Not yet.
Could you go back to what you were discussing?
You know, brothers, I promise I will come to you guys. I will come to you.
Could you give us a time?
Of course, yeah.
But I won't be forever.
If it was forever, I'm looking extremely young.
How many minutes?
Probably half an hour.
That's too long.
Well, I'm sorry. You'll have to wait. Or else come back in 4 weeks. I'll be here.
You're being so nice.
Yeah.
You don't have a queue to speak to you.
Listen, you are an engineer, okay? You are an engineer and you have to be very accurate about things. You know that. So let us do that and then I'll come back. Half an hour. I'll try. Otherwise, half an hour. Okay, sir? Yeah.
I have seen too many people embrace, and this is why I'm here.
Yeah. So many people what?
Embraced Islam. That's why she's concerned, yes. Alhamdulillah, it's okay, you can try. It's all right.
It will be through God, yes.
Brothers, when rationality is approached, this is what happens.
كيف الحقيقة يا أخي ونقذف بالحق على الباطل أو الله فيدمغوا ما هم لو يعرفوا كلمة لو يعرفوا كلمة يدمغوا كانوا
good
no praise the Lord we can now talk
here's another one how are you all right my friend you okay yeah I do apologize these brothers unfortunately were very rude but we forgive them. He's shouting again. We forgive him.
What about me?
Let us finish. And no, not you. Not you. I will take it back.
But don't worry. I love you nonetheless. Can I help you a bit?
You know I help everybody.
Okay, so
right. Okay. Excuse me. Yeah, sister. Sorry. Yeah. I'll take you back to your point. You were talking about how you know the essence that you disagree with what I was saying in terms of the essence. Yeah.
So. I know. All that on camera, but there are some normal don't Christians worry. Here too.
I know. I'm so glad we have met them. That's a good one. I like that. I'm so glad you said that. Yeah, because
I am a normal Christian.
Any example, and we would have been in serious problems. Yeah, but as you were saying about, I said any example. I didn't say you. Yeah, but that is what it is about. Now you see. All I say is, okay, let's look at it in terms of the essence. Again, these are words that we will interpret.
Yeah.
Okay?
Well, see, yeah. Like you use language three ways, right? You use it univocally and equivocally.
Sorry?
Like when we use language,
yes.
Right? We use it equivocally.
Yes.
Right? Univocally and
yeah.
Metaphorically.
Okay.
Right?
Agreed.
What I was going to say is that I see the things that you're saying,
yes.
And actually some of them I understand, and yeah, there's some ambiguity. The frustration that I have then is that how do we reconcile the fact that, because lack of evidence isn't evidence for, you know what I mean?
I know what you mean, yes. Right? Absence of evidence.
Yes, absence.
It's not evidence of absence, yes.
Yeah, and then there is still evidence of divinity that we've gone over,
yeah.
Which one you've propagated that you don't agree with.
Talked about, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Sorry, talked about.
It's and, okay.
But then there were still the others. For example, we haven't really talked about the Son of Man, so
agreed.
I do want to know what you want
yeah,
to
yeah,
say.
Yeah, 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 absolutely.
And I do want to know what you think about final conversation with Pilate that Jesus has.
Yes.
Because I feel like, yeah, the context and examples.
Yeah.
So what do you think about
I agree. You see, if you look at it, there is something very, very important which has a historical element to it, okay? The majority of the people did not believe that Jesus Christ and his mother gave birth to him supernaturally. In fact, to such an extent that some of the Jewish writings, talk about a person by the name of Panthera who was allegedly, God forbid, Jesus' mother's lover. Are you familiar with this?
Joseph?
No, some other guy. Hence the birth of Christ. So much so that Joseph himself wanted to distance himself from her. Okay? The point I'm making here is that when he said the Son of Man, what was he referring to?
I think you and I both know that that's against traditional Christian doctrine. But let's just put that aside for a second,
yeah, okay.
Right, let's just assume we're both looking at this text
yes,
without our bias.
Absolutely.
Then we still have to make certain then in Daniel when it has that claim of divinity and that claim of worship.
Yes.
Then you still have to make sense of that. Because you can say
agreed.
That he is the Son of Man. But Uncle G, you have to admit it's really weird if a man walks around and just says, I'm the Son of Man and I'm the daughter of a man. And
it's an odd use
of language.
No, I agree with you. But if you logically assess it, you may see a different picture. For example, who was the father of Jesus?
The Holy Holy Spirit or like the earthly Father?
Now, you see? Yeah, immediately. And you're absolutely right. Yeah. We have to ask two questions, not only one. Which one are you meaning? Spiritual or physical? Which one?
Yeah.
No. If he did not have a father, okay, he starts calling himself the Son of Man. Mm-hmm. In what context? What was he?
Man.
A man. He was created specifically. That is what the Bible also says. Yeah? He was created by what we would call a miracle of God. Okay?
See, this would make sense.
Yes.
If he only called himself Son of Man without another assertion elsewhere in the Old Testament.
Okay.
But that's not the case.
Uh-huh.
You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
It's not, for example, if I call myself Delilah.
Yes.
And I have... And you know, and I have a biography for myself, and there's no other reference in my gene, in my
yes, history, in your history, yeah.
Then you can just say, well, you know, she must be referring to this or that.
Yeah, absolutely.
But there is a reference of yes. Son of Man in the
yes.
Bible.
Yes.
And so,
there is no harm. You are right. You are right. The question I'm asking is, in what context is the Son of Man being used? You see, for example, if Jesus Christ.
Okay.
Now, exactly. Now, okay. If it is in a Jewish context. The rules in the Old Testament, especially the ones given to Moses, was God a jealous God? Yes. Jealous about what?
Losing his creation.
Do not associate any other gods with me.
Idolatry.
He was defending his divinity.
Very good.
If he is saying, I'm a jealous God. Yeah? Is he also suggesting, well, there are other gods?
Well, maybe not to the same extent, but...
If he isn't, then there is no option but to accept the unity of God.
Say that again.
If he is saying...
No,
you are not. No, my sister. We are having a conversation.
I'm just a little self-conscious.
No.
I'm
we
not,
are
I'm not calling you stupid. I mean, like, don't. That's presumption.
Zindagi. Zindagi. Sorry. There isn't a need. I have been coming here for a long time. And by the grace of the Creator, I've met a very reasonable Christian for the few times. You are one of them. Yeah. We've got emotional content and we've got rational content. I prefer rational content any time of the day. Even if it is for my sister. Now that's a big statement I'm making. So there's nothing for you to be concerned about. You are doing extremely well. Okay? Now, when I'm asking that if he says he's a jealous God, it excludes any element of any other God. Therefore, logically, it is pointing to the unity of God. Now, if I just take this a bit further, you see, the moment we consider Jesus Christ to be a part of the divinity, then we have to accept also the Holy Spirit as part of the divinity.
Uncle G, first I want to talk about how we use language again.
Yes, sure.
Because if we use language metaphorically, which in most religious books you do use language metaphorically, because, you know, how are we finite supposed to talk about an infinite? For example, you know, in the Diamond Sutra, how it's like you don't talk about the way, because as soon as you talk about the way, you define the way, right?
No, true,
right?
True.
So you gotta talk about it metaphorically. And so within most scriptural writings, across the board, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, Hindu,
yeah,
metaphorical talk, right?
Yes.
So now, when you say, when we have assertions about God, for example, like God being a jealous God, right? We're not saying that he is not jealous in the sense that that word is meaningless, because that makes no sense.
Then agreed. Why would it be written?
Yeah.
Agreed. Why was it written is the question.
Exactly. And when you talk about words metaphorically, opposed to equivocally.
Agreed.
You got to understand the context. So for
yeah.
a jealous God in the sense that he looks down and he's, you know, warding off other gods.
Yeah. Before you go there, you must understand that the Creator cannot have competition with the creation.
Mm-hmm.
By definition, that is impossible.
Yeah.
So, whatever the Creator is going to say is for our understanding. And if he does say something for our understanding, he is not going to garb it in language which leaves us confused. I am not saying this. 1 Corinthians 14:33 of the Bible says, God is not the author of confusion, but of peace. The question is, okay, if he says, I'm a jealous God, are we going to be imparting on the Creator limited, exactly, human qualities? Certainly not. It will not make sense. But the moment you do that, okay, then you've got to accept that the understanding of the Creator in its definitive form can only come from the Creator. Do we agree with that?
Yeah.
If it comes from the Creator and it is in its definitive form, then by definition it will be clear for us.
Say that one more.
No problem. If it comes in its definitive form, then by definition it will be clear to us. So I'll give you an example. The Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verse 29. Jesus Christ narrates from Deuteronomy 6:4. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Ahad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Ahad, one. Okay, it says, Shema Israel, hear, O Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Ahad. Adonai our Lord, Eloheinu God, Adonai our Lord, Echad, one. This oneness.
See, Uncle Jathin, what do we do?
No, if I can just...
Yeah.
When he says, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. He refers back because in the Gospel, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 4, Moses repeats this. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. God says he's a jealous God. What unity is he talking about?
What unity?
What unity is the Creator talking about? Is he talking about definitive unity or... Well, maybe. It's definitive. Now, if you take it in that context, whatever Jesus Christ is alleged to have said will automatically fall into place. So I'll give you an example. When he said, and I've repeated this to a friend, a Christian friend, in John chapter 5 verse 30, I can of my own self do nothing, as I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my will, but the will of him that sent me. When he is making a distinction between the sender and the sent, okay, the important thing is when he said, I can of my own self do nothing. Now, as a son of man, was he in physical human form? Yes, he was. Was he created in what we call a miraculous way?
Yes,
he was. Now, you find that this was a person who didn't have a human father. Yeah, God is up there.
No. A question.
Oh, sorry.
Where does it say in the Bible that...
If I can just finish.
This is part of what you just said.
No, I told you, let us finish, and then after half an hour, talk to you.
I don't know as well.
Yeah. He was created in human form.
No, I didn't say that. If you heard me carefully,
I said,
according to what we know, he was created miraculously, but in human form.
All right, go ahead.
Unless he was in another kind of form, which you haven't told us about. But as far as I'm sure, he was a human form. Yeah, because he came from Mary, I'm sure she was a human. Yeah. Oh, no, please, brother, I'll talk to you later. Yeah? So you find logic is dictating here, I can of my own self do nothing. And every time he did something, he submitted his will to God. Even at that final instance, as it is alleged in the Bible, when he says in Matthew 26, verse 36, Father, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. Now, the Muslim contention is a very clear one. Any human being who truly submits their will to the Creator is a Muslim. Jesus Christ, Moses, all the righteous prophets of God, what did they do? They submitted their will to God. They were, by definition, Muslims. The question here is this, that when we come across what you rightly point out to maybe metaphorical verses, their understanding should be based on what can be clearly understood and interpreted in that respect. Not taking the metaphorical verses and applying a literal understanding on what you can understand. Unfortunately, Christianity has made that mistake.
Yeah.
can you round up, please? Can you round up, please? I mean, because you've said quite
a bit. I'm slim, thank you.
You've said a lot of useful things, but you have also said some things that are really way out, not right.
Thank you. You are entitled to your opinion. So, but I'll finish with my sister and then I'll come with you. Yeah. So you can see there are many elements, yeah, which can take quite a time to discuss, to understand. But I know for one thing, that if we take the Bible, and you are right, as you pointed out, if you take the Bible from Genesis to Malachi in the Old Testament, from Matthew to Revelation, you will have a consistent story of how it points to the final prophet Muhammad. Very clear in the Bible. Now, on an evidential basis, I'm saying this. Yeah. Not what wants to wishfully believe, okay? But the evidence suggests very clearly. And I'm not saying it. Jesus Christ himself says it, according to the book. Yeah? When he makes claims like, you know, there's somebody else going to come after me, you know, listen to him, glorify, he'll be glorifying me, etc. You have to ask yourself, okay, what did he mean? Did he mean the Holy Spirit, as it is understood? Because if you look at the Greek, yes, it clearly suggests a human being. Okay, now one wants to know what we'll be coming back.
You said metaphorically speaking. Are you not metaphorically speaking right now?
I know, brother, you are emotional. Calm down. Yeah, you see, the question is, if you think about it, it's very clear. If he is making the claim, it goes right through, and if he is saying that, shouldn't we at least consider it? I'm not saying accept it. Consider it and see.
Uncle G,
हाँ ऐसी बात है तो आप क्या हाँ ये तो अच्छी बात हुई
कहेंगे कि मैं तुम्हें पूछना सीखा
जी
क्योंकि इससे खाना बहुत गुस्से मौसम
हाँ बहुत है हाँ हाँ समझ गया
कहेंगे कि मैंने पूरा मैंने इस्लाम बारे पूरे पता नहीं हैगा
अच्छा
और मैंने ये पता
अभी ये तो है ना आपके पास
हाँ
नो प्रॉब्लम मैं कार्ड भी दे दूंगा मेरा ईमेल के साथ जब भी आपको सवाल है पूछ लेना मुझे
When जो तो आपका गल कर दे यार
जी
पेज बारे है ना जी मैं तो जी होने आख्या कि अपन उन कंसीडर करना चाहिए
जी
पर मैंने पूरा मैं पूरा कंसीडर नहीं कर सकती क्योंकि जो तो मैं सोच दिया है ना
जी
मैंने ये नहीं समझ लाती कि मोहम्मद शुरू होके इन्ना शरीफ होके लिखता सी तो फिर एक टाइम पे ही इवॉल्व्स
No, it doesn't happen. No, it doesn't happen like that. वही तो मैं कह रहा हूँ ना आपको कि देखो ये जो subject matter है ना उसके बहुत उसमें deep जाना चाहिए अच्छा और मैं एक बात आपको यकीन से कह सकता हूँ कि बहुत जो information जो evidence है ना उसको आपको देखना चाहिए या assess it for what it is या you will have your background which you are entitled to But assess the information as it is. और मैं तो एक बात आपको जरूर कह सकता हूँ कि आपको जब भी सवाल पूछना है, तो जरूर मुझे ईमेल कर दो। उसमें कोई इतराज नहीं मुझे। I promise I will respond to you as and when you require the information.
आप यहाँ कितने चले हो?
यहाँ तो अभी कितने बज गए? 2 घंटे होंगे, 5 बजे हम चले जाते हैं। We come from 250 odd miles away, so yeah, it's quite a distance. लेकिन जैसे मैंने कहा ना, मैं आपको मेरा कार्ड दे देता हूँ, उसपे मेरा नंबर भी डाल दूँगा. Anytime you feel like asking anything, my sister, you are open. And my phone is 24 hours. It doesn't mean you should disturb me at 1 o'clock in the morning. But if you need to, by all means do.
अच्छा तूने कुछ पूछने लग गया तुसी बुरी ना मानो तो जे तुसी ना कहना चाहते हैं तुसी ना कह सकते हैं
हाँ बोलो
पर मैं कला थोड़ी चल लिए थे यहाँ ते मेनु आई सी जे अब बात चों गाल कर सके तुसी सारे जाने तुसी क्या सी तुसी दूर हो आए हैं
नहीं नहीं नो प्रॉब्लम तो ऐसा जो करने हैं ना तो बाद में कर लेते हैं या डेफिनेटली ओके यहाँ ही होगा ये जो वो टेबल है ना टेबल है ना थैंक यू वेरी मच वो टेबल एक मिनट वे इज़ द टेबल एक मिनट आ जाओ मेरे साथ वन सेकंड यस आई एम कमिंग बैक या ये कहाँ गया सॉरी हमारा टेबल कहाँ चला गया भाई हाँ ये हमारा है या तो देखो ऐसे करो 15-20 मिनट के बाद यहाँ फिर आ जाना या तो यहाँ मैं आपको मिलूंगा एंड वी विल डिस्कस इट ओके
ओके
सी यू इन अ बिट
थैंक यू वेरी मच
विक्टर वन सेकंड कैन आई जस्ट
हाउ यू गॉट हाउ यू कैन स्पीक टू हिम
सॉरी yeah no leave her. it's okay it's okay leave her okay sirs
he's gone.
Hi, how are you sir? I am Shabir. You are?
I'm Victor.
Oh good,
nice to meet you.
Sorry. Likewise, we just need to give
all,
this
just we'll am give I allowed it. To join really?
First yeah of all, of course you can
first
join
of all,
in.
Before we start first of all right do you believe in the Old Testament?
No.
You don't believe in the Old Testament?
No, but I do believe if I can you've no, asked me a question let me okay. Let me answer.
I don't want to be too long. I don't want to go into it. I don't want to go into it.
Well, sir, if you want to have a discussion, if you want to have a discussion, have a discussion. Otherwise, we are all entitled to our opinions.
It goes on too long. 2 minutes.
Well, that's because it requires rational assessment.
Go on then.
Yeah, anyway. The revelation came to Moses, Musa alayhi salam, accepted. The revelation came to Jesus Christ, the Injil, accepted. It is considered that all that information is within the Bible, but it is subject to assessment. That's my view.
Okay, have you got a copy of your Quran?
No,
Quran.
I don't.
I do.
You don't have a Quran?
It is here.
No. You don't have a Quran?
I don't have a copy with me.
Do you believe in
it? It's there, on the table.
Do you believe in Abraham?
I don't believe it is an accepted fact that there was an individual in history called Abraham who I accept to have existed.
Is
yes.
Abraham in the Quran?
Yes.
Abraham. Is Moses in the Quran?
Yes.
Is Jacob in the Quran?
Who?
Jacob.
Yaqub, yes.
Jacob is in the Quran?
Yes.
Is Yeshua in the Quran?
Isa, yes.
Isa is in the Quran?
Yes.
Is Solomon in the Quran?
Yes.
So basically you believe in all these prophets? That were in the Old Testament in
right.
the Quran?
Right. Brother, you are talking to me,
I'm
okay?
Asking you a question.
No, well, I'm going to tell you. It's not a question of belief, it's a question of evidence. That is what I've always said, and I'm consistent in what I say. Prior to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, okay, all the prophets that came, yeah, we consider to be submitters to the will of the Creator. That means they were all Muslims.
Evidence.
Yeah, I'm telling you, according
to
the Quran.
When you use the word evidence, sir, you said evidence.
If I can finish, sir.
Okay, I'll let you finish.
Yeah, so if you ask, if you...
No, I'll let him speak.
If you ask, yeah, you are being gracious.
Yes,
if we accept that they were all prophets of God, mighty messengers of God, including Jesus Christ, who we call Jesus Christ, Isa alayhi salam. Yes, he was a mighty messenger of God.
Okay, so Islam, from forget the Bible, since you say you don't believe in the Bible, right?
I didn't say that.
Oh, you believe in the Bible?
Right, let me, you see. I want you to listen, since we are having if we are having a conversation, what you need to do is be gracious enough to listen to what I'm saying. Now, apology accepted, but what I am saying to you, brother, is this. I said to you, the revelation that came to Moses, accepted, the revelation that came to Jesus, accepted. It is considered that information from that is contained within what is known as the Bible. The word Bible, I'm sure you understand, is an equivalent of a word meaning a collection of books. Now, if I were to ask you, okay, from Genesis to Deuteronomy, yeah, you have got Genesis. What else? What else have we got?
It doesn't matter.
Exodus,
you can list them.
Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. The five books that are considered to be of Moses.
Yes.
Yeah? Oh, yeah. Now, that is how it's considered. Yeah. Now, in that logic, my brother.
2 minutes.
Exactly. In that logic, we would expect the message that was revealed to Jesus Christ in the Bible. Mm. It isn't there.
All right.
Okay. Now,
two minutes for you, please.
Okay, now, Ishmael.
But brother, can I just ask, what is the subject matter?
Yeah, the truth.
Oh, okay.
The truth.
Okay.
You're discussing knowledge. You're telling me about books of the Bible. I'm here to talk about the truth.
What is the definition of truth?
No. No,
I'm asking, what is the definition of truth?
Let us exercise what you demand.
You believe.
Okay.
Which is that? You believe Islam is the truth.
I accept Islam is the truth.
You accept Islam is the truth. Okay, fine. That's what I want to qualify. Now, Ishmael, what's Ishmael's role in Islam? Ishmael.
He was the son of Abraham, and he is considered to be a long line of people then come to the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
Okay. So you believe in the Bible. Okay, now if I did a verse. No. You got it. No, I want to quote
from the
Bible.
I didn't say that.
You've been speaking from your mind.
My brother, I didn't say that.
Sir, hold on.
Go ahead.
You've been speaking from your mind.
No, my brother. Remember, I'm sorry, what was your name again?
You have the opportunity.
Victor.
Remember,
Victor,
you have
my brother.
To reply. So anything he says that you don't agree with,
okay,
you can reply.
Excellent, thank you.
You've been speaking. I've heard you speak. You've not pulled out the Quran. You've been speaking from your mind. All true. Right? Or from your mind, right? Mm-hmm. I'm going to use the word now,
okay,
right? Bible. And you've got your Quran. Because if you believe in Quran, the Quran is the word of Allah. Correct? Is the Quran the word of Allah?
Well, see, you told me not to answer. Now, should I answer?
Let's not play games.
I'm not playing games. Look, for a start, Victor, you accuse me of saying something which I haven't said.
No.
As soon as I respond,
yes,
he says, don't do it. And then when
yes
you tell me
no,
to...
Don't, let's look
right,
sir,
answer, ask again.
Sir.
Okay, you know what I'm going to do?
This,
brother.
Give me 30 seconds to say this. Let us be mature about this.
That's...
No.
I agree with you. Look.
Let us be mature about
this. One brother, Victor.
What you have just done now...
You are going to the world.
Sir, please, what you have just done now, I too can do that, but it doesn't really help.
Brother,
let us be mature.
Okay, no,
I'm trying to be. But don't you think it is only fair that when he makes a claim which I haven't made... You should tell him no, that's not true.
Okay, fine.
Go ahead.
I'm not distracted. I'm going to go back to the word, right?
Yeah.
You believe the Quran is the word of Allah. The Quran is the
I accept
Allah.
It is the word of the Creator,
Allah.
Yes.
And you said you also believe in the Bible as well. So I'm going to go...
Now see, I didn't say that.
He says that he believes in certain parts of
it. I didn't say that either.
Tell us.
I didn't say that
either. Ishmael.
Let's go to Ishmael.
I don't want to argue, man.
We are not arguing. We are trying to discuss. Yeah, okay, go ahead.
So Ishmael. So the line of Islam started from Ishmael all the way up, correct?
It's not the Islam.
No.
Where?
The prophet.
Brother, let him finish and then we respond.
Muhammad is the messenger of God.
Sorry, I've forgotten your name.
Muhammad is the messenger of God.
Martin. Yeah. Martin, yes. Can we
Muhammad,
be consistent here?
Yes.
Muhammad is the messenger of
exactly,
God.
Exactly, unfortunately,
okay,
it's not happening.
Yeah, fine. Muhammad is the messenger of God, right?
We
and Muhammad comes from the line of Ishmael.
Yeah.
Shall we have a discussion? They can have a discussion.
No. And Muhammad comes from the line of Ishmael. Yeah. Now, the Bible clearly says here, this is God speaking. Okay? Okay. I'm reading from Genesis, okay? Chapter 17, verse 9.
Hmm.
And God said, Sarah, thy wife.
It's verse 19.
Verse 19, sorry.
Yeah.
Sarah, the wife, shall bear thee a son indeed, and thou shalt call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting person, and he is the seed, and with his seed after him. So the covenant is with Isaac,
okay,
not with Ishmael.
Okay.
So?
No,
what
brother.
What do you mean so?
Brother, that's fine.
What do you mean so?
Okay, brother, yeah, all right.
He doesn't understand what that means.
Brother, Victor.
What do you mean, sir?
Victor, brother. Brother.
Now.
Brother, can I respectfully ask you not to be rude to him?
All right, let's continue.
By doing that.
Let us continue.
That's manipulation. That's what
No, no, it's not manipulation. But you carry on with what you are saying to me.
The seed, this is God speaking. The seed, the covenant, was established with Isaac. You had Isaac and Ishmael. Isaac and Ishmael, right? From Sarah. God's covenant was with Isaac, not with Ishmael.
Okay.
Now, the seed, right? Jesus Christ came from the seed of David, right? Christ came from the seed of David. It's from the bloodline of David. But Christ was the son of God, right? By the Spirit. Now, Jesus Christ, number one, is not God. Let me just make that clear now for everybody here. Christ, number one. Let me finish.
He's going to disagree.
I told you.
He's going to disagree. Victor, he's going to disagree.
Carry on.
Hey!
I told him before.
Brother, Martin, what about the Bible?
I'm on the Bible.
Don't go away, brother.
Yeah, that was not a good behavior.
It wasn't.
Yes.
I disagree with
you. Okay, fine.
That's wrong.
That's a different. I'm
brother,
I'm talking about Islam.
Sorry,
now.
Victor.
Islam.
Brother, why did you walk away?
That was wrong of me.
Anyway, going back to what you're saying, Victor. Yeah,
apologize.
Please. No, you are. Apology accepted, my brother.
Thank
go on, Victor. Carry on. You said you believe that Jesus is not God.
Let me carry on. Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Carry on.
Oh, let me carry on.
But let's continue.
I'm debating, I'm talking
continue.
To
you.
You are discussing with me.
I'm discussing
yes.
With you.
Yes. When Jesus Christ. Sorry.
Now, let me carry
continue.
On.
Carry on. Please.
I'm going, everything I'm saying is based on the word, and I will prove it. Jesus Christ, Jesus, the man, is not God. He's a human being, right? But he's the Son of God based on his spirit. Right? Now, to Islam, that's abomination to say that. Right? To Islam, they say, oh, that's an abomination.
Who said?
Brother,
now you have spoken. Can I respond?
Okay,
we can go one at a time.
Okay.
Number one, you said that the promise that was given. Yeah, was given to Isaac.
Through Isaac, yes.
Okay, and not Ishmael.
Not Ishmael.
Okay, according to the Bible.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. The first thing we have to do is establish whether the Bible is the book of God. For us to establish that what you are saying is true.
Okay.
Don't you agree, logically
definitely,
speaking?
Definitely.
So, what evidence can you proffer to me that this book is the book of God?
And what evidence can you provide to me that it's the Quran? Is the
no
Quran
problem. After we have done that, we'll do that one.
Okay, now, first of all, in the Bible, in Timothy, the Bible is the word of God. The man wrote the Bible. I'm not denying that. Man wrote the Bible. The Bible says in Timothy that
right,
the word,
brother. Hold on, Victor. I'm just about to say, if you were to calm your voice down, right. Listen to me, brother.
I'm an African, brother.
Victor. Victor. I'm an African
so
as well.
And you should be used to
it. Okay. Now, basically,
I'm proud of it. I'm not going to.
No, absolutely. There isn't anything.
I'm a man.
Hey, African ladies scream even louder than you. So don't go down to anywhere. Yeah, go on.
I'll try my best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Please, if you can.
Now, in Timothy, right, the yes. Bible is written by man.
Where does it say that?
It's written in Timothy.
Show me, please.
I don't know the exact verse.
Timothy 3:16.
Exactly. But it's there, though. You agree?
No, read it. No. See what it says.
Read the verse before it first.
It's this side.
No, Timothy is at the end.
At the New Testament.
New Testament.
Mm. Are you familiar with the Bible?
Not really.
Yeah. What do you mean? I don't have to memorize all the verses.
No, you don't have to. Now that I know you are an African, I don't mind your voice.
Where is it?
2 Timothy second, chapter 3, verse Timothy, 16. Second 3, verse 16.
And all scriptures given by inspiration of God,
yes.
And profitable for doctrine, for reproof, correction, and for
instruction unto righteousness.
Now, what does that mean?
Yeah,
the
what does it mean?
It's inspired. It's inspired into men.
Okay.
And also, they don't believe in revelation knowledge. You don't believe in revealed knowledge.
Brother, can I suggest something to you, Victor?
Yes.
We are discussing the Bible now.
Yes.
Don't confuse yourself with the Islamic perspective and the Christian one.
Why not?
I'll tell you why.
Why not?
I'll tell you why. Because when you are reading inspiration, okay, and I did say, for us to logically accept your contention about Isaac,
but logic,
brother, let me finish.
Are two different things.
Wait, we'll come to that also.
I'm so happy you said that. Somebody's actually beginning to say something of
logic and spirituality.
You want
two
to,
brother,
things.
Victor?
Sir, can you logically
from your mind? Can I finish? For God's sake!
I was going to ask. Could you logically please allow
just
me to
a joke,
ask
brother.
This question?
Oh, okay, you can. But can I just finish and then you
okay,
ask?
Let him finish. Then you.
And then you can ask the question. Okay. Yeah. You see, brother, like I said to you. For us to accept your contention that Isaac was the promised one from which the lineage began through David to Jesus Christ, I said, well, first we have to establish whether this is the book of God. To which you responded, well, what about the Quran? I said, yeah, okay, we'll finish with this and we'll go with that. But the question here is this. 2 Timothy 3:16, the verse says, all scripture is inspired of God. Yeah? For doctrine, reproof, correction and instruction unto righteousness.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yes, I agree
now,
with that, yes.
Now, what I would ask you, okay, what does that verse tell us about the Bible being the Word of God?
The Word of God. Now, I'm going to go by what Yeshua said, right?
Fine.
Now, Yeshua says, right, you should love God with all your heart, all your mind, right, and Him only should you worship. And the only way you can serve God is through His commandments. Right, it's through His commandments.
Okay.
Now, the commandments are in the Bible, right? Like loving your neighbor as yourself, coming on yourself. But basically, because Christ has died on the cross, which Islam,
they don't believe in Christ, because Jesus Christ has died on the cross, right? He died for the cross as a sacrifice for the sin of humanity. Now, like I mentioned, the New Testament mirrors the Old Testament. Okay, remember where Isaac, Jacob was about to, Abraham was about to sacrifice his son, Isaac, on the mountain, right? And God said, "Don't sacrifice your son," and He gave him a lamb, right? God did exactly the same thing in the New Testament, but sacrificing Jesus Christ as a man, as an atonement for our sin. That means, as believers, you now live by the grace of God.
Okay.
By the grace of God.
Okay.
Not by works.
Right.
Not by growing your beard. Okay. Not by washing your hands.
Not by circumcising yourself.
Not by circumcising yourself.
Okay.
Not by doing all of those things.
Right, good.
You live by the grace of God.
Okay.
And number one, I believe in God.
Yes.
I believe in one universal God that created every single thing in
Excellent.
Here. Man, woman, everything. There are no two gods. There's only one God. Right? From the beginning of Genesis to the end, even Christ himself, just like I said himself, that I've come to do the will of God. Now you may call God Allah, or call God this thing, right? But the bottom line
can I just clarify one thing before you continue?
Yes.
Are you saying that you do not accept the idea of the Trinity?
Me? There's only one God.
No, I'm asking you a question.
I don't believe in the Trinity.
You don't believe in the Trinity at all?
No, the Bible says,
yeah.
Right? By the Son, I mean, like this, glory be to the Father,
there
the Son.
Hold on.
The Bible says, glory be to the Son.
Sorry, what does the scripture say?
There are three that bear witness in heaven.
Weakness or witness?
Witness.
Don't
witness.
Sir, please, let's be mindful.
No, I'm being.
The Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Word,
and the Spirit.
Right, where is that? One. Where is that?
You don't know where it is.
Where is it?
You know it.
Where is it?
You, but you know it?
Where is it? Just pull it out.
Which version you have?
Oh, whatever, man.
Yeah?
Because it's some version you don't
go on.
Are you a Christian?
That's a good one.
Exactly.
First John, yeah.
Yeah, it's 1 John chapter 5, verse 7.
First John.
Go to it. And just
and
read.
Also, just because you can quote the Bible
Victor.
Left to right doesn't mean you're righteous.
Absolutely.
Victor.
I agree
so
with you.
Let's just finish that now.
Absolutely.
What does it say?
Oh, record.
It is recording behind you.
Record.
What?
Now,
what? Sorry? What was that?
There are three that bear record in heaven.
Hmm.
The Father,
yeah.
The Word,
uh-huh.
And the Holy Ghost. And these three are one.
Right. Excellent. What do you say about
no,
that?
I haven't finished.
No, I'm
asking him.
No, not you. I'm still reading the Bible.
Wait. We are talking about the Trinity.
I will explain.
Yeah, please do.
Wait.
We are talking to Victor.
You can finish later. It is the same scripture.
I have to speak to that sister again in 20 minutes, I told her. So I want to speak to Victor.
It also says this.
Victor.
And there are three that bear witness in art.
Yeah.
The Spirit,
the water, and the blood. Yeah.
And the water and the blood. And these three agree in one. Look at the difference. Agree in one.
Yeah.
And
well, actually, brother,
anyway,
Victor, before you go further, this particular verse that we referred to has been changed to mean exactly like verse 8. Okay? Now, one second.
Would you listen?
Yeah. Can you explain, please? Wait, I'll come back to you.
Victor, what
do you say about that verse?
Please, when you finish that, give me.
Yes, we've already said yes.
When you finish in 5 minutes, please allow me to talk.
Okay, go ahead,
and
Victor.
What
do you say about that since you don't believe in the Trinity?
Now, the Father, we already know the Father is God.
Yeah.
Correct? We already believe the Father is God. I believe Christ is the Son, right?
What kind of Son?
Yeah, he's the Son of God.
What
just
kind?
Like you are, we're all sons of God.
Yeah, so it's nothing special.
So to be left, okay. It's not. I've never said Jesus Christ.
No, I'm asking.
One,
yeah, okay.
Right? I've never said that.
All right.
So you have God the Father, the Son, who is Christ. Jesus
not
Christ.
God the Son.
Well, I believe all of us here are sons of God.
According to the verse, is he God the Son?
Who?
Jesus Christ.
It represents human beings. It represents humanity.
Brother, I'll ask you
the
again.
The Bible says, yes, he's the Son of God.
Is it God the Son?
God the Son, yeah. He's the Son of God. Son of God.
Where in the Bible does like, say
no,
that?
No. Hold on. No.
Can you guys agree and disagree and then come back to us? I think it may be better.
No.
Yeah.
In the Bible, when he was being baptized. I'm going to paraphrase. When he was being baptized,
yes,
he said, "This is my beloved son, with whom I'm well pleased." That's what he said. Why are you talking? I just showed you where he said it now. That's in the Bible, and he knows it's in the Bible.
Yeah, it is.
No, so this is my beloved son.
Yeah,
with whom I'm well
pleased. In whom I'm well pleased.
Jesus Christ was
his son. With whom I'm well pleased. So that's why I look.
Right, but
then again, in the Bible it said, Victor, those who are led by the Spirit are sons of God.
But I want to answer that question.
I want to go back to that question.
About
the Spirit and all that. Now, the Father is God.
Ah.
The Son is Christ, which I've just defined right now.
Yeah.
And the Word is the Spirit.
Okay.
Christ said, "The words I speak to you are Spirit and life."
Yeah.
So the Word is the Spirit.
Right. So when
you say the Trinity, organized religion.
Right. Sorry.
I was taking that.
Yeah.
Sorry,
Victor.
Yes.
I'm just asking.
Yes.
So when, according to Jesus, he said, "Go ye out into the nations and baptize in the name of the Father,
the Son,
and the Holy Spirit."
Yes.
You mean it the way you said?
Yes. So the Son,
not the way he means it.
I don't know.
He believes in Jesus as God the Son, not the Son of God.
What do you mean God the Son?
No, that he's the Son of God and he's also God the Son.
See. Yeah, now, you see, brother, wait. In the context, look, our discussion was about whether this is the book of God, okay?
Can I now answer that?
Let me just...
We haven't got to the Qur'an yet.
No, we haven't, absolutely we haven't.
I asked you a question, can I answer? Please, allow me. First and foremost, when all the books of Moses were being written, you believed that they were written by Moses, didn't you?
No, I didn't say anything. I said revealed.
Do you believe it was revealed?
Yes,
to Moses?
Yes. Now, I accept it was
when
revealed.
When Moses was going to receive his revelations, there was a criteria for him to be believed.
According to the Bible. Okay.
So that
can you show me that criteria, please?
I'm saying it if you allow me to.
Oh, please.
Now the criteria is simply this. Now he was at the mountain where God himself came down, and the children of Israel, about 3.5 million people, were present, and they saw the appearance of a fire on the mountain, and Moses himself was approaching unto God. Now the children of Israel, who were witnesses of the relationship between God, the revealer of his truth to Moses, told him, "Please, you go and speak to God. Let God not speak to us directly, because we are afraid we might die of this." That's 3.5 million people who are physically present to see the one who is the Most High God.
Yeah, but Wait a minute, let me finish.
I'm not saying that. I'm merely saying, let's assess it.
Would you let me finish?
Look, brother, Martin, where did you get a 3.5 million figure?
I gave you time, sir.
Yeah, I'm asking.
I gave you time.
Oh, I thought you had finished. Sorry, sorry.
Let me continue.
Apologies.
The truth about the matter is this: there were multitudes of witnesses.
Sorry?
A whole country?
What did you say?
There were multitude of witnesses. Israel, a whole country?
No, you said 3.5 million. Where did you get that figure from?
He just made it up. Fine.
No.
It's not in the Bible. Hold on.
Victor, are you saying he just made it up?
Can I finish?
No, he just said it.
Can I continue? All right.
Yes.
Now, to make issues clear, a whole nation heard God.
Brother, don't run away from me. Could you let me finish? Look, brothers. You know the issue I have with Martin, listen to me.
I'm trying to discuss with him.
You have done something very intelligent. No, brother Martin. Can I finish with him and then come to you?
You have spoken on a regular basis and you have not allowed me.
I agree, brother.
I got his permission to answer you and you are interrupting me.
Are you giving him permission to discuss with me?
It's not representing my point.
There you are.
Good.
Thank you. Now, if he's not representing your point of view, how can I discuss with him?
Did I get your permission to speak, sir?
Yeah? Look, Victor, my brother.
Did I get your permission to speak?
You're speaking, you can speak. It's a free word. It's a free word. I'm not stopping you.
Good. So can I speak now?
It's not about that. We started a conversation.
No.
Brother.
Don't, see.
Okay, I'll drop yours. You start.
Who speak?
Victor, don't go away. I want to talk to you. You are sounding, he's taken, he's hijacked it. Yeah. Go for it.
Sorry for hijacking. The truth of it is this.
What
I'm trying to point out to you is that of all the prophets,
yes,
who wrote the books in this Bible,
yeah,
whenever God
was
speaking to them,
right,
or whenever God wanted to use them as a prophet,
okay,
there were human weaknesses about their weaknesses.
Okay.
For Muhammad,
yeah,
even during the times of his inspirations.